What's up guys, Charles here. Resizable BAR is a feature that has become a staple of the industry ever since it was announced a few years back. The technology, which is part of the PCI spec, allows the CPU to have access to the entire GPU memory space through the PCI interconnect, thus removing any bottleneck and offering higher performance. Let's take a look.
So we've had a discussions about resizable BAR.
Yes.
Right. So I think there's two parts to this. One, maybe describe what resizable BAR is.
Yeah.
And then the second question that I think most people want to know is, we've been very open about Intel ARC architecture is more sensitive to resizable BAR.
Turn it on.
And it needs to be on, essentially, for a reasonable experience with the product.
Yes.
So let's first, what is resizable BAR?
Resizable BAR is a pretty weirdly named PCI Express feature. And what it does is it allows transactions that originate on the CPU, like reads and writes, that are targeting GPU memory, to be bigger. So basically, if resizable BAR is off and you're trying to read or write a large memory region, you're going to do a lot of little transactions. Normally, that's no big deal. You know, maybe some people like a lot of little transactions. Our memory controller on our GPU happens to like fewer bigger transactions. And it has to do with the way the memory controller is designed and optimized for different memory technologies. But suffice it to say, if you bang on our memory controller with a lot of little transactions, it gets a little, you know, you know what I mean. So turn ReBAR on. So let's think a little about when that would happen.
Okay.
So in games, you don't normally read GPU memory. You normally write GPU memory.
Mm-hmm.
And that happens when you're like loading a texture, you know, it's copied from the CPU's memory to the GPU's memory. And the GPU executes out of local memory all
right.
the time. The GPU often does not like read the CPU memory. The GPU is often working on a local GPU memory. Similar, like a shader is getting moved over to the GPU or geometry is being moved over to the GPU. And it's almost always a write of a big chunk of data over to the GPU. And that happens on things like scene changes or when you load a new level or there's a new effect happening. So that's why when you look at these bar charts, when you look at these frame time charts, you'll see ReBAR off will generally result in spikes that were already there getting bigger. Right?
Okay.
So it's not like the average is affected as much, but some of these spikes get big. And it's because it's those momentary transactions where you're moving data across the PCI Express interface.
So adversely affecting game experience as opposed to maybe average frame rate.
Yeah, you're going to see an average impact. And you see this, by the way, not just on Intel's GPUs, you see it on NVIDIA and AMD as well. It's just that we're more affected by it because our memory controller is more sensitive to small transactions. But all of these scene transitions occur on all GPUs, and it's really just a question of optimization.
Got it. So
AMD popularized the idea of enabling PCIe feature called ReBAR, resizable BAR, on consumer GPUs through the introduction of smart access memory technology. NVIDIA was quick to adopt their graphics cards to support this technology by offering a patch for GeForce RTX 30 series, and motherboard makers followed suit by enabling this feature on more motherboards. The tool called ReBAR-UEFI can patch the UEFI firmware and enable support for this feature on even broader spectrum of motherboards. However, there is still an issue of enabling ReBAR on older GPUs themselves. While initially supported on certain GPUs and motherboards, resizable BAR support has extended to lots of older platforms, but it looks like some of the most popular mainstream GPUs were lacking this support, such as NVIDIA's GeForce RTX 20 and GTX 16 Turing GPUs. NVIDIA has even stopped the production of these GPUs, but several GeForce gamers are still using them since they can be bought off the used markets for dirt cheap rates and still deliver decent performance. We recently reported how the GeForce GTX era ended this year. Once again, due to their popularity and usage, these older NVIDIA GeForce RTX 20 and GTX 16 GPUs can still benefit from resizable BAR. And since there's no official driver or UEFI support, an unofficial UEFI driver known as NVStraps ReBAR has been made to enable such support. It is reported that older GeForce 10 Pascal cards are not supported, but RTX 20 and GTX 16 series GPUs are. A range of configurations were tested, and it looks like the resizable BAR support is indeed working. By enabling ReBAR allows the GPU to negotiate the size of the BAR base address register with the motherboard. This tool can enable auto setting, or it can be confirmed manually. Nonetheless, one must point out that this mod involves patching the UEFI firmware on the motherboard, so make sure that you know the risks involved. Moreover, check reviews comparing ReBAR-enabled and ReBAR-disabled GPUs to understand whether it's worth the hassle. NVIDIA is not expected to provide a solution to enable ReBAR on GTX 10, 16 and RTX 20 cards, so this may be the only solution available. All modern GPUs come with ReBAR enabled, and some cards even require ReBAR platform support. like Intel Arc. You can find the required files and full guide by following the link below. Do consider subscribing for all the latest content on the gaming, and as always, I'll see you in the next one. Peace out!